Hello and welcome everyone to my channel The Storytellers. In today's video, I will tell you about pronoun. Pronoun are the words which are used in place of a noun to avoid repetition of noun. Let us take an example. Ram is playing in the park. Ram will go to study after that, which means noun Ram is repeated twice in these sentences. But we can say that Ram is playing in the park. He will go to study after that. So, to avoid using Ram multiple times, we used a word which was he. So, this he will be a pronoun. In our daily life, we use many pronouns like he, she, it, they, we, us, etc. Let us take a look how many types of pronoun we have which we use in our life or in general language we do. There are 10 types of pronoun: personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, distributive pronoun, reciprocal pronoun, emphatic pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, interrogative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, and relative pronoun. And now we will learn about them one by one. Let us take a look to personal pronoun. Personal pronoun, as their name indicates, they are used in place of a person or thing. Means they are used in place of proper nouns when there is only a singular thing or only a singular person. Now, they are used at multiple places in a sentence. According to that, they are divided into three cases. And these three cases are nominative case, when the noun was in subject, as we have seen in previous sentence. Like in this sentence, Ram is playing in the park. So Ram was in subject part. In this sentence, when Ram was replaced by he, it was nominative case. But instead of this, if sentence might be he is going Moradabad. So when this Moradabad, which is in object part, this is also a noun because it is a name of a place. So when this Moradabad is replaced, then it will be a objective case. Like he is going somewhere. Wo kahin ja raha hai. So this noun is replaced. So this will be objective case. The third and the last is possessive case. Whenever possession is shown, or this is shown that thing belongs to someone, like this pen is mine. So the word mine shows the relation that this pen belongs to me. So this mine will be possessive case of pronoun. Let us take a look further. It will help you better to understand the pronoun. Now, the pronoun we use in our daily life are of three person: first person, second person, and third person. Me, who is speaking, will be the first person. And to whom I am speaking will be the second person. And we two, I, me, and you, are talking about whom, that will be the third person. Means जो बात कर रहा है वो first person है, जिससे बात कर रहा है वो second person है, और हम दोनों means मैं और second person जिसके बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, that will be the third person. Now how we can use different pronouns in different situations, we will learn with the help of this table. When there is only singular noun, I, me, mine, myself are used. In subject we use I, in object we use me, in possessive case we use mine, and in reflexive we use myself. We will learn the uses in further slides. When it is second person, we use you for singular and plural. Same for object, and for possessive case we use yours and yours. and in reflexive we use yourself and ourselves. For third person we use he, she, it, and in plural we use they. Him, her, it are used in object and them is used when object is plural. In possessive case we use his or her, and when possessive case is plural we use theirs. Next is reflexive, himself, herself, itself. For respectively he, she, it, he ke liye himself, her, she ke liye herself, it ke liye itself. And when it is plural means they, so them, they will be converted to themselves. Now let us take a look to reciprocal pronoun. Reciprocal pronoun is when an action is done in both the directions, means A is doing something to B and B is also doing something to A, then it will be called as reciprocal pronoun. Let us take an example. They helped each other. उन दोनों ने एक दूसरे की मदद की. Means इसने भी इसकी हेल्प की और इसने भी इसकी हेल्प की. A helped B and B helped A. तो reaction done in both the directions. Whenever this situation happens, it is called as reciprocal pronoun. And how we will find out? Words like each other or one another will be in the sentence. Look at this sentence. They helped each other. Each other word is used in this sentence. Similarly, one another. This word is also an indication of reciprocal pronoun. Let us take further slides. Next is demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronoun, as their name indicates, they demonstrate. They tell us something. What they tells us? That what is the position of a person or a thing. Means, is it far to us or it is close to us. And words like these, those, this, that are used. For example, those pens are on the table. And when we read out this sentence, those means they are far from us. They are many and they are far from us. So it indicates distance. These pens are mine, means the pen are close to me. So this will be demonstrative pronoun. Hope you might have understood that. Now coming to interrogative pronouns. These pronouns ask questions like what, why, who, whom, all the WH words are used as interrogative pronoun. Now, how you will find out that they are pronoun? Look at the sentence. What is the time? In the answer of this what, a noun should be there. Because in the answer, you will tell a number and the name of number is also a noun. So, when a noun is replaced by a question word, it will be interrogative pronoun. Coming to the further slides, relative pronoun. These pronouns are used to join phrase to phrase, phrase to clause, or a phrase to a sentence, or clause to clause, clause to phrase, or with another sentence. Same for the sentence. They join sentence with a phrase or with a clause or with another sentence. Let us take a look with example. I met a boy. It's a sentence. Main ek ladke se mila. Stood first in the class. Class mein sabse pehle khada hota hai. Now this word who. This word who joined these two sentences. That I met a boy who stood first in the class. Main us ladke se mila jo class mein sabse pehle khada hota hai. So this will be a relative noun because it related these two sentences. Coming to the next one, which is indefinite pronouns. They don't have definite number as their name indicates. Kuch bhi confirm nahi hota hai ki hamare samne jo number diya gaya hai wo kya hai. Refers to a person or thing in general way. Means there is no specification that what or who is doing the work. All, someone, nobody, anybody, few, many, little. These words are used to indicate indefinite pronoun. Whenever any of these words is there in the sentence, it will be an indefinite pronoun. Let us take a look with the help of example. Someone has stolen my purse. Now, this someone is uncertain. No one can say who this someone is. So this is an indefinite thing. कोई भी हो सकता है, हमें नहीं पता who someone. So it is indefinite pronoun. Let us take a look for further slides. Distributive pronouns. They denotes that a thing is in singularity or in group. Means either there is only one thing or there are many things. Like each of you go home means har ek. Each means every one of them. So they are talking about one or singular thing. So it is telling the distribution. Or all of you go home. Tum sab ghar chale jao. So they are talking about group. All the people who are present there. Or all the students who are in the class. So this will show the distribution. Means either they are one or many. Such pronouns are called as distributive pronouns. Whenever either, neither, each, all, these words are in the sentence, they shows that it is a distributive pronoun. Next one is possessive pronouns. Here you must be knowing the meaning of possessive. Possessive means the thing belongs to someone. Whenever it is shown that the thing belongs to someone, कि कोई भी चीज किसी की है, so there will be possessive pronoun. They shows the relation or something which is related to someone, like mine, your, etc. Let us take an example with the sentence. This book is mine. So this book belongs to me. So this word mine shows possession. It will be possessive pronoun. So it will be possessive pronoun. And words like my, yours, his, hers, these words shows possessive pronouns or indicates the presence of possessive pronoun. Next is reflexive. Next is reflexive and emphatic pronouns. Now they all both are same. There is no difference between these two. Same words are used to show reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun, like herself, myself, hisself, themself, ourself, etc. But the major difference between these two is that reflexive pronouns are used in object part and emphatic pronouns are used just after the subject. This way you can easily identify whether it is a reflexive pronoun or an emphatic pronoun. Let us see the definition as well. The pronoun, those who shows the action is done by the subject. They are called as reflexive pronouns. Go through the sentence. She hurt herself. Usne khud ko chot maar li. So who had done this thing? She. She is the one who hurt herself. Usne khud ko chot maari hai. So she will be doing the work. She is doing the action. So this will be reflexive pronoun. As you can see, she hurt herself. Herself is an object part. So this will be reflexive pronoun. On the other hand, when reflexive pronouns are used to emphasize, they are called as emphatic pronouns. I myself met the officer. Main khud officer se mila. To yahan pe kya hua? I ka emphasis hua. The emphasis of the subject is shown in the sentence. So it will be emphatic pronoun. And here myself is used just after I. So this way you can easily identify that it is emphatic pronoun. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel so that you can get the notification of further videos. Thanking you. Signing off.